Hi everyone. One of the most important panels of Adobe After Effects is the timeline panel, which I will teach you in this video. For this tutorial, I first open a project. You can download this project with all its files below this video and practice this tutorial. From the file menu, I click on the Open Project option and open this project. In the project panel, a composition is created along with the files folder. Also in the timeline panel, you can see the layers. There is a video layer and 5 Photoshop layers where we can make changes to the layers. Sometimes you need to double-click on the composition to see the layers in the timeline panel. The composition panel will show you the image of the layers. In the timeline panel, when I click on any layer, 8 square dots are created around that layer in the composition panel. Also, by clicking on the image of each layer in the composition panel, that layer is selected in the timeline panel. On the left side of each layer in the timeline, there is an eye symbol that we can click on to hide or reveal the layer image. After that, there is the solo option. If we activate it for each layer, we can only see the image of that layer, and the images of other layers will be hidden. The next option is lock. By activating it for each layer, we can no longer select that layer or make changes on it. There are small arrows next to each layer. If I click on them, there is a transform option. If we have already made changes on the layer, you may see other options such as effects or masks in this section. For example, this layer has both effect and transform options. Next to the transform option, there is another arrow that I click on. There are other options here that we will explore together. These options are available for all text, image and video layers. The first option is anchor point. Whatever layer we select, there is a circle in the center, which is called an anchor point. 8 other small squares around it are used to change the size of images or texts. The image size changes by left-clicking and dragging. There are 2 numbers in front of the anchor point. By changing them, we can change the location of the layer in the X and Y directions, but the location of the anchor point does not change. Do this by holding the mouse over the numbers and dragging. The next option is position, which works exactly like anchor point, with the difference that this time the location of the layer and the anchor point are changed at the same time. The scale option changes the size of the layers. When I change one of the numbers, the other number will also change, so that the size of the layer will change evenly in length and width. But if I click on the constrain proportions option to hide it and change the numbers again, the change is applied to each number alone. In this way, the appropriateness of the text or image is lost. The next option is rotation, which rotates the layer. The first number on the left applies the number of rotation times. For example, I write the number 2 to apply 2 times 360 degree rotation. In future lessons, I will teach you how to make a keyframe. I make this number 0. The next number only applies the rotation once from 0 to 360 degrees. I am writing 50 degrees. You can see that a 50 degree rotation is applied to the layer. The opacity option also changes the resolution value of the layer. This number can be changed from 0 to 100. As you can see, now, if you want to return the settings of the layer to the default state, just press the reset button. All numbers return to default. In the other part of the timeline, there is a time indicator that when I move it, it displays all the frames of the video or animation over time. In this way, you can see the movement of birds and other project changes in the composition panel. At the bottom of the timeline panel, there is the possibility of zooming in the timeline, which makes us see the frames and keyframes better. After you zoom, you can move the timeline by moving this slider. You can do the same by using the slider above. In the time roller section, you can see the number of seconds and frames. For example, I put the time indicator in frame 20. The letter F represents the frame. Now I put the slider at 1 second. In 1 second, the number of frames is 0. You can see the time on the left side in every frame when you stop the time indicator. As I said in the previous lessons, the first number is the hour, the second number is the minute, the third number is the second, and the fourth number is the number of frames. We can also write the desired time and frame here, so that the time indicator is placed on that frame. For example, here I write the time of 2 seconds and 15 frames and press the enter button. You can see that the time indicator is placed on that frame. Also, you can change the location of the time indicator by holding the left click and dragging. In front of each layer, there is a bar that shows the length of the layer's display. We can also change the location of each bar. Notice the blue cube layer. Each layer is displayed in the composition panel only when the time indicator is on the bar of that layer. We can also make the bar smaller or bigger by placing the mouse on the edge of the bar and dragging it. Also, you can use right and left bracket shortcuts to shorten the bars from the beginning or end of the timeline by stopping at the appropriate frame. And it is possible to change the color of each bar. Just click on this square and choose a color. If I put the time indicator at the end, you can see that the length of this composition is 5 minutes and 8 frames. Also, there is a work area at the top where we can shorten the length of the project. It is enough to place the mouse on its edge and drag. You can change the start of the project in the same way. You can use N and B shortcuts to shorten the work area from the beginning and end of the timeline. For example, if we render the project now, the project will start from second 1 and end at second 4. You can change the work area by holding the left click. Friends, the timeline panel in After Effects is very extensive, and we will examine more of it in the following tutorials. Now you are familiar with the timeline panel. I put the link to this project below this video, be sure to download and practice. To see the continuation of the training, please subscribe so I'll see you next time.